Bienvenidos al curso a distancia de Fultenda. En él, usted encontrará en una forma sencilla y práctica la forma de adquirir nuevos conocimientos. El mismo consta de un manual con contenidos teórico y práctico, una guía de estudio, fichas de evaluación y un DVD con los conceptos fundamentales del mismo. Ahora, lo invitamos a buscar un lugar cómodo y tranquilo, lápiz y papel y manos a la obra.
So welcome. My name is Daniel Maple. I'm the developer of the Wild Earth Animal Essences. And I'm pleased to welcome you to this introduction to the essences that accompanies the manual, which describes in more detail some of the things we'll be discussing today. I live on a farm at the base of the Blue Ridge Mountains in the state of Virginia in the United States. And there in the mountains for the past 15 years, I have been honored to serve as a bridge between the animals and humankind, working as the developer of the animal essences. So what are the animal essences? Well, they are made in the tradition of flower essences, except the animal essences don't contain flowers. They contain the vibrational signature and energy of animals, allowing us each, when we work with the essences, to receive the gifts and wisdom of wild animals. So I make the animal essences in the wilderness of the Blue Ridge Mountains, near my home. And the essences are made in a ceremonial process where I connect with the spirit of the animal and make the animal essence that then is available to you. Each of the animals has a number of special healing gifts and qualities. The animal essence can help us balance ourselves when we are out of balance. And each animal essence also has a specific spiritual gift that it offers us. For example, eagles, which fly closest to the sun, high in the sky, is the essence for helping us to connect to God or spirit or the divine or the goddess, whatever you call the great eternal. Turtle walks on the earth with its shell of protection. And the turtle essence, when we work with it, allows us to experience that protection in our own life so that the energies of others or environments that are difficult for us do not come in but stay out. And butterfly, the great being of transformation with this amazing life cycle from pupa to flying butterfly. The butterfly essence can help and support us when we are going through external or internal changes of any kind. These are the kinds of gifts that are available to us through the animal essences, and I feel so humbled and honored to be able to help the world uncover and discover. So people often ask, so Daniel, how do you make these essences? And what I say is that I make them in a ceremonial process in the wilderness of Virginia, in the United States. I'm always by myself, out in nature, in a place where I've been going to for many years. A clearing in the forest, a very peaceful place where I feel my connection with the animals at its most deep level. People say, so do you see the animals or what is it like for you? And I say, well, my relationship with animals is sort of like gravity. We're all walking through our lives on 2 feet all day long and we don't really give a thought to the fact that gravity is supporting us in doing this all of the time. It just is there. And my relationship with the animals is similar. I feel a natural, spontaneous, ever-present ability to connect with them whenever I wish. I don't see them clairvoyantly. I feel their presence kinesthetically. And often I will feel individual animals coming to me with specific messages and guidance. Other times I will call on a specific animal and immediately feel its presence by my side. So when I'm making an animal essence, it's just in the wild, it's just a natural extension of this very organic and normal relationship for me that I have with the animals. And the ceremonial process, when viewed from the outside, is very simple. Just seeing a man placing a bowl in the center of a clearing, a bowl of water, and then the man going to the edge of the clearing and walking slowly in a spiral, silently, in a meditative, prayerful way. When I get to the center, you see the man lifting the bowl of water to the sky for a moment, And then the bowl is placed back on the earth. And then the man just walks back out in the other direction. At one level, it's a very simple ceremony, a very quiet ceremony, not a lot of drama or bells and whistles. Internally, of course, it's altogether different, because as I spiral into the circle, I experience my connection with that animal getting stronger and stronger and deeper to the point when I'm at the center of the circle, I, Daniel, am there, but the presence of the animal is most strong. And it is that point where I lift the bowl and feel the energy of the animal joining with the liquid. Someone once said that success is 1% inspiration and 99% perspiration. And this moment, this time, this ceremony in the forest is the 1% inspiration, where everything really happens at the core of my work. And the rest, the other 99% of the time, is me doing the necessary and laborious work of building and growing a business, bottling and selling and traveling and teaching and making videos and doing all the necessary things that are important to help the world learn about these remedies and benefit from them. I'm often asked, so Daniel, how did you come to this work? How did this all begin? And I often describe two initiations that I experienced and went through that led me to the point where I was ready to serve in this way. The first was what I refer to often as an initiation into the outer wild, and the second was an initiation into the inner wild. The first initiation into the outer wild took place when I worked in my teens and 20s as a wilderness guide in the Rocky Mountains of the United States, primarily around Yellowstone National Park. And this was the time when I learned to be among truly wild creatures in their habitat and environments away from human civilization for weeks at a time, especially being in the habitat and the land of the grizzly bear in Yellowstone Park, where I was the visitor, always having to be vigilant and aware that around me there was this animal that was potentially a danger to me. And that gave me great respect not only for the bears, but for all of wild nature, how truly we are one with nature, and yet we are often, because of the way we live in modern times, we are often the visitor. And I would come to those wild places with great respect and openness and the willingness to learn from these creatures. This was the initiation into the outer wild, along with my time living in very rural Africa, where I worked as a community development worker for 3 years in a very remote African village, where there were lions and elephants and poisonous snakes around as part of the landscape. The second initiation was altogether different but equally important, and this was an initiation into the inner wild, into the depths of my own heart, which was brought about through a great path of suffering that I had to travel through. Until I was 27 years old, I thought I grew up in the perfect family where everybody smiled all the time and everything was perfect. And then, through a series of very bizarre circumstances in that family, the family started crumbling apart, and all of a sudden, I was awakened from a very deep sleep, a very deep slumber of denial that I had been in since I was a young child. And thankfully, I was blessed to find a wonderful therapist named Barbara, who guided me through that dark night of my soul for a period of 3 years, going through the really deep, scary emotional work of healing this deep trauma. And coming through that trauma, I really found my heart, and I found myself, and I knew who I was. So it's those two initiations into the outer wild and into the depths of my own heart that prepared me to do this work, and that I believe allow me to come to it in a spirit of humility and service, because I'm not looking to the animals to make me somebody. I already know who I am. I have a deep sense of comfort with myself and my path. And while it is a joy to serve the animals in this way, it's not something I'm needing. And because of that, I feel like I'm able to serve in as clear a way as I possibly can without needing anything from them, and to just serve them in a spirit of gratitude to be able to play this role, and in a spirit of joy and playfulness as well. Animal essences and animals are much more energetically complex than flowers or other vibrational remedies. Because of this, each animal essence can actually work in a variety of different ways. For example, cheetah, the fastest, the animal that can go from 0 to 100 kilometers per hour in 6 seconds, is wonderful when you need a jump start, when you feel kind of stuck and you need to get moving. It's also really good when you need to have real focus and clarity and be able to move, get a lot done in a really short period of time with focus and agility. It's also really good as a tonic, works beautifully as a tonic for living in these stressful modern times where our bodies are moving much faster than they've been used to in human history. And in this way, cheetah is the best remedy of the animals for burnout, when our adrenal glands, which are the glands that pump out all the hormones when we are under stress to help us cope with stress and with speed, cheetah helps balance all of that. There are many individual animals where you can pick an animal to help bring balance to a place where there is imbalance or suffering, or to support the spiritual gift that those animals have. There are also 7 main combination formulas, saved by the animals I described, our emergency stress formula, for example. There are also 6 wild child essences, the baby animal essences, that are a series of essences that address some of the deepest unmet emotional needs that we have from childhood. There are many of us walking around as adults who didn't get our primary needs met as babies and young children. And these essences are equally good for children who have these unresolved issues and adults whose inner child has these unresolved issues. The need, for example, the baby dolphin calf is the essence for attaching and bonding. So it's wonderful for those who never felt a deep connection of love or bonding with their mothers or fathers. The wolf pup for feeling like addresses the need to belong. So it's really good for people who question their children or adults who, when they were children, question, where do I fit in? Where do I belong? For example, if they came from families with separation and divorce, wolf pup is the wonderful remedy to address that situation. And you can learn more in the manual about each of them and how they address these primary needs. There are also the 7 healing path essences, which is a sequence of essences which is designed to provide support, emotional support, for many of the natural stages of the emotional healing journey. From our place of suffering and separation, when we're in pain and not sure how to move through our darkness, all the way up through letting go of our past and moving into gratitude and freedom, and finally communion with God. In addition, there are 4 energetic sprays that combine the individual essences of either dolphin, eagle, butterfly, or dove with essential oils, with the scents, the very organic and wildcrafted scents that I have chosen specifically to complement the energy of the specific animal essence. So there's a number of different ways and different paths for you to work with and encounter and grow with the animals. So when working with people with very deep, unresolved emotional wounds, when the people are struggling with issues that go way back, usually to childhood, then the best essences to choose often are the wild child essences and the healing path essences, because these 2 sets are designed to really work at the deepest levels to address these unmet emotional needs and wounds that have gone untended for a long time. And to that I would also add the Save by the Animals combination to help the person feel grounded and spiritually open as they travel through their darkness into the light. There are a number of other essences in these busy modern times and in these times where we're all growing so much that come up a lot and are often very beneficial. I mentioned the cheetah before. Cheetah is great for dealing with the stresses of modern life, especially the physical stresses. Butterfly is the essence, the gentle essence of change for support of both outer change and inner change. And this is a time when all of us are growing and being forced to change It's a time where if we resist change, we will suffer. But if we say yes to change, we will flourish. And Butterfly is, in essence, to help both of those types of people, those who are resistant to change and those who want to embrace it even more. It's very gentle. It's very soft. It can be used whenever we are changing our external circumstances, moving our house, changing job, changing relationship, going through life changes such as birth, death, adolescence, menopause. All these periods of change are wonderful, wonderfully supported by Butterfly. And it's also good whenever we are going through periods of inner change, inner transformation. Equally important and useful. Badger is an especially useful essence for anyone dealing with issues related to anger. Whether from people who are inappropriate with their anger and don't know how to express anger appropriately and do harm to themselves and others and physical things with their anger, all the way along the spectrum to people who say, oh, I'm never angry. I've never been angry in my life. Anger's not spiritual. I'm beyond my anger. People in denial of their anger. Anger is a natural human response. And in order for us to be fully grounded and balanced human beings, we need to embrace anger as a natural thing, not something to be pushed away or something to be given too much energy to, but something that can just arise and that we can allow ourselves to feel and express when needed appropriately. And this is Badger's gift, to support us in coming into a healthy relationship with our anger. So this is one example of how an essence can work in a variety of different ways. And this is a great blessing because there are many, many animals and they can serve in so many different ways. And it can also be a challenge when deciding, okay, what essence is it important? What is the right essence for me to prescribe or use for myself right now? And in this regard, what I found is that the essence, that the people who make the best essence practitioners and those who are most effective at choosing the right essences for themselves and others are those who aren't only willing to approach the animals with their thinking minds, learning and reading, like working with the manual and the repertory at the back of the manual and figuring out with your thinking mind which essences are right for which situations. But equally important to that is learning to listen to one's inner voice when developing one's relationship with the animals. And opening one's heart to the animals, being willing to work with them with humility and respect and allowing them to become one's teachers. People who just want to memorize a list and say, okay, which one of these essences will I give this person with this problem? These people never have great success working with the animal essences. It's only those who are willing to open their hearts and allow the animals into their hearts, which means also opening themselves to all of their feelings, opening yourself to your pain and your joy at deeper and deeper levels, saying yes to all of your experience, not with your head, with your heart. These are the people that make the best essence practitioners. People that are able to balance the use of their thinking minds and their questioning analytical self, and also people who are able to rest and live in their heart, listening to their inner voice and allowing the animals to guide them. Another combination that I'd like to briefly mention is supreme confidence. And I want to mention it because it has such a broad area of application. We all are living in times when we can benefit from having more confidence. And supreme confidence is a formula that's designed to impart confidence and to give you a jump start and the ability to act with that confidence. Supreme confidence has mountain lion, which mountain lions have the energy of moving forward steadfastly on your path, one step at a time with commitment and focus and clarity. Bumblebee, this big insect with these tiny wings that seemingly accomplishes the impossible in flight. Bumblebee imparts to us this ability to go beyond our limitations, to accomplish what we think is impossible, to blast through your personal limitations. And cheetah, to give us the jump start, to get us up off the chair and moving with this confidence. Supreme confidence is an incredible formula for helping people, children, young adults, seniors, who feel like there are limitations or goals they need to achieve, but one wonders, how can I do this? Supreme confidence imparts this energy of, yes, I can do this. So people often ask, so how do I work with the essences directly? What do I do to make them most effective? The essences are sold in stock bottles, and essences can be taken directly from the stock bottle if you wish. Generally 2 to 3 times a day for 2 to 3 weeks, optimally 3 weeks to allow the energy to fully do its work. Stock bottles, however, can also be used more efficiently, rather than taking the essences directly, to make up what are called dosage bottles. To make up a dosage bottle, you need to get an empty 30 ml bottle and fill it at least 20% with brandy and the rest with distilled or spring water. Then you open your stock bottle and take 5 or 6 drops of the stock bottle and place it into your new bottle. Then place the cap on the new bottle and shake it. And what you have now is a dosage bottle ready to use and take. So each stock bottle can make many, many dosage bottles. So it's a very efficient way, if you're willing to do the little bit of work required, to make one stock animal essence last a long, long time. Okay, so once you have your dosage bottle, you take 5 or 6 drops in a number of different ways, usually directly on or under the tongue, 2 to 3 times a day. They can also be put in a small glass of water and drunk. You can also put them in a bathtub in your bath, swirl it around, and then get in. They can be placed in the drops in the palm of your hand and rubbed into the feet, especially children and elderly people. This is a wonderful way to allow them to experience the essences by rubbing them into their feet. You can also put them into a spray bottle with a mister and mist yourself and others or the space that you're in. And there's lots of other ways to use them as well. The key with working with the animal essences is always trust your inner voice. Listen to what feels right and trust it. When an acute situation arises, when a crisis arises, it can be effective to use an essence much more frequently than the 2 to 3 times per day. Our saved by the animals combination is our emergency and crisis and stress formula. Saved by the animals is best to use whenever there is a sudden physical or emotional shock, or when you're going through a period of intense stress or crisis. When using saved by the animals in an acute situation like this, it's best to use the essence frequently at the start. And the model we often recommend is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Take the essence, and then about a minute later, take it again. And then about 2 minutes later, take it again. And then about 3 minutes later, take it again. 4 minutes later, and then 5 minutes later, gradually extending the number of minutes between doses. So that over the course of your first hour, you will have a significant number of doses, and then you can begin to taper off to once every 15 minutes, once every half hour, then up to an hour, and then to your 2 to 3 times a day if the crisis continues. This is an extremely effective way to benefit from the strong support that is offered and saved by the animals when an acute situation arises. So I want to say a few words to you. Thank you for taking the time to listen to me today and for opening your heart to the possibility of receiving the gifts that the animals have to offer you. And I just want to share with you from the bottom of my heart the love and guidance and strength that is available to each of us if we are willing to approach the animals with humility and respect and to look at them as teachers. Again, not just with our thinking minds, but with our hearts. And obviously, because you're listening to this today, you have this capacity. You are one that is being called to by the animals to open your heart to them and to listen. And I'll just remind you, leave you with one word of advice, is to, with for your life with and journey with the animals, but for your life as a whole, always trust your inner voice. Don't let anyone ever tell you that your inner voice is not the most important voice of all. All the external voices that scream at us from the television and from society and from our families and from the newspaper and from the internet, from all these other corners, those voices all have their place. But the most important voice of all is your own inner voice. And you have my total support in honoring and listening and trusting that. And the animals are totally here to support you in that journey as well. So I offer you my love and my blessings and my joy and my bliss. And may your journey, may your whole journey, and may your journey with the animals be blessed.